Hello, I'm the RPG Chick. Look at that thing slid open again. Welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. Having an awesome time with this game, of course. Really enjoying myself. I'm actually hoping they'll come out with a DLC for it by the time I'm done with this main game. I'll have a DLC to look forward to. Now, our Durance, a character of Durance, has the highest mechanics, but his is only 3. He needs a minimum of 4, and being assisted with lockpicks. In order to get in this door, and possibly the others, we'll have to see. There's another door here, but I didn't bother looking there yet. Kind of want to check this open area out. That's my way. Check out open areas first. Then everything behind doors, and then, you know, go deeper, and then once we've cleared an entire level, go up or down to the next level. I'm sure there's someone in here. Could it be you? Let's see, there's another stairway. Ah. Another acolyte. Sure to meet his demise. Before he even runs over here, he'll probably be dead. But I'm sure there's some friends of his in the shadows as well. Imagine if these things came alive and started stomping after us, too.
Eh?
That'd actually be pretty cool. What else we got? 2 acolytes. If this was modern day, there'd be a water cooler right here, and they'd be talking about the new secretary or something. Down. Oh, paladin right there. We're sorry, Your Holiness. You've forced our hand. Because if we have no idea if this guy Kolsk is on the level, we're just slaughtering this entire fort. Moments of doubt. How they plague me. Knockdown. You know what? Knockdown on him. Kind of making me choose different targets now, just so I can knock them over. They're probably gonna run out of range, but what the hell? Holy Radiance. Magic missile type thing over there. And amplified thrust over here. Zoom in a bit. And go.
This isn't
fair. Should have thought of that before you know, started defending yourself. Ooh, drove him right through.
Lava.
Haha. Yeah, attack. Knock down, she didn't even use it yet. Someone will get one in. Soul Shock. Off of Eder. Still not actually sure how you say his name. I'm not sure if you've heard it pronounced. We did cast that. I'd say we're fine. Yeah, just have him wade in as well. And here we could do a arcane assault here.
Huh?
Ah, another one. Oh boy. Okay. Help us. We need armor or something. Oh, why'd we get switched? The hell? Armor. Armor up. And she's out of focus, so let's attack. Yeah. Necrotic Lance here. Did he cast it yet? I told you to. I guess his foe was vanquished. They cast it here then.
Yeah.
Still got a knockdown in us. Or, what's her name? Firebrand does. Recall Agony on this guy. God, 54 burn damage. Ouch, Firebrand.
Nice and slow.
Oh yeah. Great swords, maces. Money, simple clothing. All the normal stuff.
Sure.
Thanks for that. That will aid us in our quest. Okay, so we got upstairs here. More open areas.
Sure.
Not sure where to head to first. Oh, we got food laid out for us. Thanks. We were hungry after all that fighting. Got some foodstuffs. Yay, we love foodstuffs. Ooh, got beer and spirits. Concocted by the most daring of brewers, spirits come in many forms and flavors, but they all share the virtue of hurling everyday problems into a sea of liquid fire. And then afterwards, you can just be hurling, so there's that too. Alrighty then. Interesting. Alright, we're continuing this way. More foodstuffs. Oh, they got the turkey laid out. Look at that. Looky here. Rice, vegetables, and fruit. Very healthy. Very healthy. Fortunately, it didn't, wasn't healthy enough to stop you from dying by us. Alright, so that's that. So really all we've got left is this upstairs and these doors. Let me check out those doors. I don't know if we can even get through them, so we might be back here pretty quickly. Oh, wait, wait. One more. Can't open these, we'll be right back. Really? Oh! Priestess and priest. What are you up then to in there, you naughty people?
A.
A. He's been damaged a bit. Let's hope we can all get past each other. He might be stuck. Who else is... Who's this? Durance? It's Firebrand. Let her move past. Theodas and Aeloth are fine like that. Ada will move up. Well, maybe he can find his way around here. Amplified thrust off of Eater and... Arcane Assault. Here, looks like he's just gonna stand there and cast a spell, so we might be looking at both of these guys. Holy Radiance. Oh, we knocked him already? Shoosh. Firebrand. Move up. Oh, she's stuck? Why is she stuck? Who's stuck? Why are we stuck? Grazes. I don't know. Divine Mark? She might be just technically stuck because she's there. And she can't, you know, she's stuck somewhere. she still has yet to cast her thing? Oh no, she got interrupted, I guess. Off of Eater once again. He's stuck behind everybody.
Yeah.
So Eater can knock him. Well, she's not stuck anymore. Good. Can you knock him? Can you get past us? Probably not. Durance, move over here. Oh. Never mind. Crisis over.
Quickly and quietly.
All the normal stuff.
Oh. You can trust me.
Can I? Sometimes I'm not that sure. A drawer. With a scroll of defense. This tightly wound scroll describes the means by which to cast a broad enchantment of protection upon one's allies. Though it requires all to stand within the circle of its influence in order to benefit from it, the spell greatly increases one's ability to ward off attacks by raising their reflexes as well as providing magical resistance against harm. So friendly AoE, plus 20 all defenses for 15 seconds. Sweet! I wonder if Theodas can use that. The Iroccian... It's been a while since we found books, guys. I'm pretty sure we haven't found this. Iroccian? 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 Annie Iroccio, the New Year. While only 150 years old, and of Valian origin as well, the Iroccian calendar is currently used throughout most of the Deerwood and the surrounding areas. While the Deerwood was using the Iroccian calendar until recently, they gave it up in favor of the Iroccian calendar. The transition was easy to get people to make because the Iroccian calendar was hopelessly inaccurate. Iroccio calculated that it takes the planet approximately 334 days to orbit the sun, so he took the 9 months from the Iderian calendar and broke them into 16 months of 20 days each. Interesting. With each season consisting of 4 months. The length of each month corresponds to how long it takes Balafa, one of our moons, to circle the planet. They write this like as if people don't know what the moons are. At the end of each season, 3 days, not part of either season, are set aside for people to celebrate the transitions. Lastly, the final 2 days of the year, New Year and Mid-Year, are used to observe the beginning and midpoint of the year. To prevent any confusion for the transition from the old calendar to the new, Iroccio kept the year the same, so although the calendar has only been in existence for 150 years, it is currently 2823 AI, Anni Iroccio. Wow, and he gets credit for that, big time. Iroccio gave the months Valian names, but in the Deerwood and surrounding areas, they call them by their translated names. The year is broken down in the following way. New Year. A day to celebrate the arrival of the new year. Of all the holidays, this one is celebrated by most people around the Deerwood and the Valian Republics. Each new year is greeted with a fervent zeal to begin things anew and start with a fresh slate. Winter months, two at the beginning of the year and two at the end. Deep winter, Fonaverno, and late winter, Falotaraverno, or Verno, however you say it. Spring dawn, 3 days. In Prima, used to celebrate the transition of the world, rebirth, and spring. Eothasian festivals are especially prevalent at this time, or were, prior to the Saints' War. Spring months. Early spring, Pre-Prima. Mid-spring, Maj-Prima. Deep spring, Fan-Prima. And late spring, Tor-Prima. Summer rising. 3 days. In Estu. A period of transition from birth to growth. Many ceremonies designed to usher children into adulthood take place during summer rising. Summer months and mid-year. Early summer, Priestu. Mid-summer, Majestu. Mid-year, a day of reflection and introspection. The year is half over. People who made promises on New Year use mid-year to assess their progress and renew their oaths. Interesting. So you can look at your New Year's resolutions and say, I'm half over and I really haven't even started that diet. Deep summer, Funestu, and late summer, Tarestu. Autumn falling, 3 days. Inauton, I don't know. Harvest celebrations happen during autumn falling if the crops were particularly bountiful. If the harvest was small, supplication is given to the gods asking for a better harvest the following year. Autumn months. Early autumn, Priautan, mid-autumn, Majautan, deep autumn, Funautan, and late autumn, Tarautan. Winter dusk. 3 days. Okay, they tell us how to say this one. In Averno. Winter dusk is filled with celebrations of life and vigils for the dead. The world is returning to sleep, plants die, and those still alive raise a toast to another year. Winter months. Early winter, Priaverno, and midwinter, Mazaverno. Interesting. The Iroccian calendar, everyone. Now, here be scrolls. The Many Faces of Berath. How fitting that we know the god of cycles, doorways, mortality, and inevitability as Berath, while the Valians know this very same god as Serono. For if nothing else, Berath teaches us that duality exists in all things. There is life and death, and death and life. Embrace this duality and you honor Berath. In the ruins, Ir Glanfath, Berath is depicted in the form of two semi-skeletal figures, one male, one female, Bunin I Anku and Anku I Bunin, literally life and death and death in life in the Glanfathan tongue. Male and female, inside and outside, life and death. We often think of Berath by imagining two sides of coin or two endpoints of a journey. It is said that Berath has the most petitioners of every god, and this is likely true. Who amongst us has not prayed for this cycle to hiccup? Who has not, in a moment of sadness, yelled at Berath to make an exception for our fallen loved ones? Berath may not rescue our loved ones, but it answers our prayers in its own divine way. Berath is the god that makes life end in death, but it is also the god that makes death end in life. Berath, Serono, Bunin I Anku, Anku I Bunin. Whichever of the many names you prefer to use deserves our prayers, for it has given us the promise of life's eternal renewal. Sounds weird calling a god it, though. So we're finding books, not scrolls. The Deerwood Part 5. Well, we haven't read the others, so we're just going to hold on to this. As well as Deerwood books. I mean, I think we have 1 and 2, don't we? Part 1. 2. And 5. Okay. So we need 3 and 4, obviously. Here's a potion of minor regeneration. 15 golden dukes. And a scrawled note. I got your gift. I can't believe someone actually wrote down that kind of thing on parchment. I left something for you in the chapel. Careful not to go digging in the wrong skull again. Huh. In the wrong skull. What the hell does that mean?
Huh?
It's the, that's, yeah, selects everybody. Okay, can we get out this way? Good. Oh, you're kidding.
I can do that.
No, you can't. We need a lot more levels and mechanics to do that. We need to really have someone specialized in a certain amount of stuff, like someone really good at lore, someone good at mechanics, and then of course they can never leave the group because we'd be screwed. Alright, so... can't get in there, how frustrating. I think we've destroyed everybody. Except for people behind locked doors.
Nice and quiet.
You know, it'd be cool if you found someone behind a locked door, or we find a locked door, and we make enough commotion outside so that whoever's inside, you know, comes out. And then we can get in. That's unfortunately the things you can't really do with a computer role-playing game, you know, unless it's specifically programmed in. Hello? Let's save here. This looks pretty important. More books, guys. It's been a while since I read any books. Guys may or may not have missed it. Oh. Nedmar? What do you think? Should we bother trying to converse with him? Yeah. This frail old priest is hunched over a table surrounded by scattered scrolls and parchment, examining their contents with the aid of a thick monocle. He glances up as you approach, blinking rheumy eyes. More visitors, then. You're not one of the acolytes. or the guards for that matter. His voice is a dry, quiet rasp, which makes you an intruder at the least. Kulsk put you up to this, I suppose? Yes, that would be him, sending young women to dash themselves against the keep's defenses. Really? Did he say that? Or is he trying to... Yeah, does he know we have women in our party? That's pretty interesting. He shakes his head. Would that my sermons could draw such fervor. Still, you are here. What is it you want? I'm only here to pick the place clean. How did you know I came here on behalf of Kulsk? Nedmar studies you quietly for a moment. My eyes may be failing me, but my wits have not. Kulsk has recruited what allies he can, and he has begun to strike against the keep in earnest. It has not been long since his latest effort. As I predicted, and as you can see, the attempt was a disaster. Kulsk is unwilling to grasp certain truths, nor does he understand what it is that he keeps Raedric in power. He will need much guidance. If he means to take Radric's place, I can only hope he would listen. Eder says, a good thing his predecessor set expectations low, then. You don't seem to think much of this Kulsk fellow. It's not that. I simply disagree with his methods. We have known each other for a long time. I remember him as a young lad. It makes it all the harder to see him act this way. Impulsively. Blindly. Nedmar frowns. He and his followers have brought more harm than good for all his good intentions. But I do not wish him harm, and so I find myself caught within their struggle for power. He raises the bony finger. But neither Kulsk nor Raedric can resolve this crisis. They are but mortal men. We must turn to Berath. It is the twinned god who will bring peace and balance to the souls of Gilded Vale. And it is to Berath that we must pray if we are to see Widewind's legacy ended. I'm here to face Raedric. Will you help me? Nedmar's brows knit together in an expression of mournful regret. I don't know that I can. I have tried to warn Kulsk and his people of the dangers. I have, in truth, tried often to sway them from their path. My efforts do not seem to have made any difference. Eder says, play nice with the fellow that wants to kill you and all your friends. Can't imagine why they wouldn't listen to sound advice like that. Even poor Giacco? Giacco. I don't know how to say that. I thought he, at least, might be saved. But he's Osiris now. No. Osiris now. Man, these names... Fodder for her experiments. He bows his head, setting his trembling hands upon the table for support. I have narrowly escaped suspicion. Raedric is in the grip of grief and will not be swayed. He will bring his wrath down upon those poor prisoners. He shakes his head, and I cannot shoulder that guilt. I cannot bear it. Tell me about Giacco. One of my acolytes. Nedmar's expression crumbles with grief. I found him begging in the street when he was but a young lad. I took him in. I hoped he might grow within the church, take my place when I grew too old to serve Lord Raedric. A bitter note enters his voice, but he took an interest in Kulsk's efforts, his vain rebellion. I could not keep him from leaving. And now, he has joined Kulsk against our lord and lingers in the dungeons. I fear he may have already fallen victim to Osria's evil designs. You mentioned Osria's experiments? Osria, a bright young woman corrupted by the teachings of the Animancers. She has filled Lord Radric's head with blasphemous notions and false hope, preying upon his desire to guide his people. And he has been foolish enough to listen. Raedric has given Osria leave to conduct what experiments she will. Now the lowest reaches of the keep are foul with the smell of rot. Who knows what souls dwell, lamenting, in that darkness? Animancers, Aloth says, his lips twisting into a frown. Why am I not surprised they're involved in this nonsense? I begged Lord Radric's forgiveness on my acolyte's behalf, but I think I have only delayed Jacko's fate. He shakes his head. He is at Astria's mercy now. If I save Giacco, will you help me reach Raedric? I could give you the means to enter Radric's chapel below. That would put you beside his throne room. Nedmar's voice trembles, but I cannot risk it while Giacco is in danger. If you can see him safely out of Astria's reach, I promise you, I will do my best to help you. He looks cautiously around the room. Oh, this will do you more good than a disguise. We have a passphrase. It is, from every ending, a beginning. Say that and the guards here will leave you be. On this floor alone, I'm afraid. Radric's sellswords have little patience for such things. I want to see what it says. There's no time for this. Give me the key, old man. Nedmar straightens a little, though his hands tremble. Would you act as rashly as Kulsk? Threaten an old priest? I will not aid you in this until you have rescued Giacco. That is all I will say. For a second I thought he was going to attack. Nope. Berathian Scripture. Behold, thou faithful, the visage of thy transformation. Fear not the journey where the portal opens. Become one with the wheel, with glad heart and cheerful countenance, for the doorway shall open for all in their time. Neither the rich nor influential, neither kings nor rulers, neither the strong nor powerful can escape its embrace. Berath will usher thee through the doorway, and thou wilt return to life, thy mortal life begun anew. There goest the cycle, there goest life, there thou goest also. Thou shalt approach the door, the inevitable shall approach thee. Do not turn back on the portal, do not turn back on new life. Walk the path and welcome change, or face the night. For he walks the road with thee, and will guide all to their destination. Thou mortal, the skull, thou wilt become. Thou closed off, the key thou shalt turn. Thou sealed, the threshold thou shalt cross. Cool. Done. Before I look at more books and stuff, I'm going to call an episode. We'll look at this stuff. I'm not sure if he'll be happy with us taking this. And then, well, we can go in here and look around. I'm guessing that the key goes here to that door we couldn't get through. With the unbelievable mechanic of 8 or something. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you in the next episode. Endure, and enduring, grow strong.